Hello students, I am your course instructor Dr. Chaya BM. So in this video we will look into what is input output subsystem. Input output subsystem, it is simply called as an IOSS. IOSS is the one which is an efficient program that is present in an operating system. So what is the function of an IOSS? It is the one which is used to enable the programmer to perform input or output operations. Apart from this, it also holds the details of the devices. So IOSS also holds the details of the devices of input output devices. So this IOSS also deals with all the problems of several tasks attempting to access the same device. Suppose if T1 and T2 wants to access the same device D1. So this problem is addressed by this efficient programming, that is IOSS. Device control block. This is the most important block that is present in the IOSS. So without this DSP we cannot get any details of the devices. So device control block is basically used to get information about the devices. Basically we have two types of informations in DCB. The first one is device related information. We can get device related information in this DCB. DCB is nothing but device control block, okay? And we can get data related information. When I say device related information, what does that mean? So you can get the information about the device address and physical address of the device and device status information type of the device and so on, ISR address and so many other informations we get. So when I say data related information, we get an information about the number of bytes to be transferred. And we get an information about whether we have to transfer the information in terms of ASCII or binary, and data area address information, also current byte count. So basically when I say device control block, it is nothing but DCB. It is a very important block that is present in IOSS. So it is nothing but it holds the information about the devices, as simple as that. So there are two types of informations present in the DCB. First one is device related information, data related information. General structure of IOSS. So in the general structure of IOSS, what we can understand is that, so you will have an input output manager, so which always accepts the system calls from the application task. So which always accepts the information from the application task. Here we will have something called application or user task. Okay. So we will get information using system calls. So the IO manager accepts the system calls from the user or application task and transfer the information contained here into the device control block. So it transfers information to all the device control blocks present here. So then the typical DCB contains following information. We know that what type of information the DCB holds. It holds the information that is present in the system calls. It holds the information present in the system calls. For example, it can have data related to amount of data to be transferred. I repeat, it can have data about amount of data to be transferred, type of data, status of the devices. So then once it sends all the system call information to the DCB, the DCB understand what type of information it has received and the actual transfer of data between user and the device. The actual transfer of information between user and the device will be carried out through the driver. So we will have a driver software for every device. So device 1 has its own DCB and driver, device 2 has its own DCB and driver, like that for 3 and 4. So actual transfer will actually taken care by the device driver. So what is this device driver? It is nothing but a program to control a particular type of a device. It is a program to control a particular type of a device. So what is detailed arrangement of the IOSs? You can carefully see the detailed arrangement here, wherein again we will have an user task or an application task which is sending its information in order to communicate to various devices like device 1 and device 2. The IO manager is the one which accepts information or from the user task using system calls, and it will send to various DCBs. So in the previous general structure of IOSs, we saw there are different drivers for different DCBs, whereas here we have a single driver which is serving or sharing the information between several devices. You don't have to use multiple devices. In the detailed structure of IOSs, we can have a single driver software which is used to share the information between several devices. So either a DCB can transfer, actual transfer is through the driver. So a DCB can send its information to device 1 or through the ISR. So this is the general structure of IOSs. IOSs, system commands for RTOS. So the first command is DTRC01. DTRC01 is disk transfer request. Disk transfer request buffered is nothing but it is memory occupied. Again we have disk transfer request, that is DTRC02. It is also the same, it is disk transfer request non-buffered. So we don't know whether it is the memory is buffered or non-buffered. We simply write this command as DTRC0X. Next, we have INR. I'm just mentioning few of the commands here. So INRC01 is input request from keyboard. So the command is input INRC01, input a request from keyboard. Again we have INRC02, it says call to check for the completion of input request. Call to check for the completion of input request. So like this we have some more commands, that is this is all about INR. Next OUCC01. So what does this mean? It is nothing but a command to check the status of the devices. Status of devices. Or this can also be used to request any system area. And so on. So this is OUCC0X. And we have two more commands maybe we can discuss. That is FMRC01. That is find and reserve. Find and reserve area of memory. Memory for what? For external, external to the calling task. External to calling task. Similarly, we have one more command, that is RMRC01. That is just to command user to check if scans are completed. So these are the various IOSS system commands for ActiveOS. So to summarize the contents in the video, so what we understood here is that we understood what is IOSS. It's basically a program or an efficient program in an operating system in order to perform input or output operations by means of system calls. We should never forget the information is always conveyed by using system calls. We saw the general arrangement of IOSS. Before that, we also looked into what is DCP. DCP is the one which holds the details of the devices. It's just like TCP, which holds the details of the task. We have something called device related information. This is not data, it is device control block. So we understood that there are two types of information. First is device related information and data related information. We saw the arrangements of IOSS. So we also understood what is the importance of driver in the IOSS. Driver or a device driver is nothing but a program to control a particular type of the device.